Home tab in MS Excel 2007. Here I am demonstrating three group of home tab. One is clipboard group, second font group, and third is alignment group. Home tab consists, clipboard consists cut, copy, format, printer, and paste command. Clipboard is a temporary storage where cut, copied contents are stored. So now I'll take the commands of clipboard. Cut, used to remove the selected test or object which can be cleared from the selection area and it stores to the clipboard. So here I have the text. I'll cut this and I'll paste it into other column. Copy command. It is used to copy the selected test or object which is not cleared from the selection area. So here again I'll use this copy. I'll select this and wherever we require in place to use this paste command. So the difference between this cut and copy is when we use the cut, it cleared from the selection area and it stores to the clipboard. When we use copy command, it duplicates and it is not cleared from the selection area. Paste command. Paste command is used to paste cut or copied text or objects. The shortcut key is Ctrl V to paste the cut and copied contents. Next, here we have this format printer. To copy and apply the pre-formatted paragraph, cell styles, borders, etc. So here we have already previously we copied the contents. So here we will apply, we'll make it this is bold, we'll make it this is underline, and this one is underline. Okay, and we'll change the one color of this cell. Now here we'll select this and same I want to apply for this. So for this we use this format printer. So we select and apply. See, this way we can apply, we can use the format printer command. Font group. Font group is used to change the font face, font size. We can increase or shrink the font. We can make the bold, italic, underline. We can apply the borders. We can apply the shade and font color. Font. Font face. It is used to change the font face, or we can select the font from the list. So the fonts which are installed in Windows. So that list here, and we can select that font here. So here it lists you all the fonts which are installed in our computer systems. We can select that font and we can apply for our data or text. Second, font size. Font size is used to change the font size of the selection. So here default it shows as 11. We can change according to our needs. See, just select the font here. For example, here I am selecting the font, and from the font face you can change the font face, you can change the font size. Next command is increase font size. To make the text bigger, we can increase the font. So similarly we can decrease, we have the decrease font size. So shortcut, we can use this bigger font size, increase the font size, or decrease the font size. Next is bold, italic, underline. So now I'll take it again back as a 12 size, and to make this text bold, click on bold. Make the selected text bold. I command, it is italize, used to make the selected text italic. Underline, used to make the selected text underline. It offers different styles of underline are available. From the drop down, it shows two options to us. One is underline and double underline. So here for font, I'll use this, and here I'll use this underline, and for this clipboard I'll use this double under. Next we have here borders. So from the borders we can apply various borders to our text: bottom border, top border, left border, right border. For example, here if I select this box, I can apply this bottom border. For this box, if I want to apply this on the top border, I can use this top border. So now top and bottom border is applied to this cell. So left border, you select here and apply the left and apply the right. So this way. And for all, if we want to, you select the text or data and you can apply all borders. And if you want to remove all the no borders, we have the option here, you can click on no borders. Next is fill color command. We can fill the color for particular cell or selected range, and it background, it applies the cells and make them stand out that way. For example, this. So here top down we can select the themes and we can apply for our text. So right now I'll take as a white only. Next, here we have this font color. We can change the font color for our text. Select the text from the color palette. From the drop down we can select any color which we require and we can apply. Alignment group. Alignment group, here the commands are left, center and right, top, middle and bottom. These commands are used to align our text. For example, here to align this left, this is already in left, and to make center the content, use this center, and to make this content right align, right align. So to view the contents in this, here we use this top align. It aligns the text to the top. Align center, it aligns to the center and aligns to the bottom. So this way we can align the text. Next we have is orientation, that it allows to rotate our text. Select the text, make the center, use this. So any angle wise we can place the text this way. It lists you the options to you. We can select any options and we can align the text. So we can rotate or we can place the text on any angle. So that is the use of orientation command. Next, wrap text. Suppose if we want to place any text, this is all the text. Wrap text command. So it wraps the extra long text into multiple lines. So we can see it here, for example, Microsoft Excel and Microsoft Excel. So for example, I'll type here, welcome to MS Excel. So this, you select the text and click on a wrap. So this way it is automatically fit to the column or in a row, and you can adjust it according to your need. Merge and center, it combines and center the text into one cell. So now this welcome to MS Excel in one cell. So I'll take two cells here, two or three, so D, E, F, and I'll make it into one cell. Click on this merge and center and click on this center option.